being our fantastic guest host, comedian Stephen K. Amos is here in Australia with his latest tour, Welcome to My World. Now, you have been touring pretty non-stop at the moment. You're off to the Opera House next week.
Yes.
What is the oddest thing about being on the road, do you think?
I think one of the oddest things is that, because, well, my job being a comedian is to try and find the funny in stuff.
Yes.
So I've always looking from the outsider's point of view. That's why I love coming to Australia, because things happen here all the time that's just a minefield of wonderful comedic material.
Like what? Yeah.
Like when I flew in here through 3 years ago, for example, the headlines around the world then was about the financial crisis, doom and gloom, negativity. And when I arrived here 3 years ago, your headlines everywhere was no bananas. And I was, what? No bananas. The wind, the water, yeah. Bananas. They ran away. Yeah. Well, I was just like reading the paper. Who lives here? Monkeys? What's all this fixation about bananas?
Very important.
So, do you know, that's why I mentioned Newcastle, for example, because I'm looking at it from my point of view. And so things that you guys might not realise or see for yourselves, I'll point it out like an outsider.
Yeah.
Like coming to Australia again, your turn of phrase here is wonderful.
Mm.
Wonderful. It's just majestic. It's lyrical. I was in Brisbane and for us it's quite hot in Queensland, and I met a taxi driver who was wearing shorts. I thought, wow, that's weird. You wouldn't see that in England. And all I said to him was, I don't know, I hope I can say this on TV. I said to him, well, how do you cope with the heat? And he just went, mate, how do you cope with thrush? What?
And did you say canister and some natural yogurt?
Well, I was just like blown away.
Amazing.
I don't even know you. And then he carried on. He went, you just tolerate it.
There's always something happening here. I love it.
And so you must measure your trips to Australia by the number of prime ministers we've had since the last time you were here.
The last one was here. It was Mr. Abbott, who was a comedian's gift, I have to say. And yes, you've had 5 prime ministers in the last 5 years, one of them twice. Hilarious! It's like you're good at sports, you're good at all that kind of stuff, and now you're trying to make another Olympic sport about having how many prime ministers you can have. Yeah. And, you know, and it's like there's more intrigue and backstabbing than in Shakespeare's Macbeth. It's brilliant.
Now, you might have seen this headline yesterday, we have to show you. Things tourists in Australia find surprising. What do you find surprising about Australia?
Oh my God, what I found, there's two things, and bearing in mind I've been coming here about 8 years, I only discovered a year ago that you guys actually raffle meat.
Raffle meat.
Now, you say it like it's normal.
Is this not something that happens in the UK?
It happens in the north of England, and it's like a tradition from the old working clubs and all that stuff.
Yeah.
But if I said the word, and they raffle meat in London, the whole audience would be like, oh, my, really? And I tried that line here, and the whole audience would be like, yeah. What's your point, mate?
I actually entered a meat tray raffle at my local pub one Friday night, as I did every week, and I came third, and they gave me a tray of vegetables.
Oh!
And I said, take that back.
That's like a hipster pub.
Yeah, I don't know what was wrong with them. I said, oh, should we just keep this behind the bar for you? He said, yeah, keep it. Keep it forever.
I would not be impressed with that.
No.
I mean, I've heard of, like, the seafood tray as well, which just sounds pretty disgusting, really. Do you know what I asked? I said to somebody, well, you would eat raffle meat? They're like, yeah. And I said, how does that work? And the guy in the front went, you buy a ticket. I know the concept. I'm familiar with the concept of buying a raffle ticket. But just the idea of somebody going, meat on a tray.
Maybe because we're raffling meat on a tray is the reason all of our cab drivers have thrush. You don't know.
Stephen Amos, I've got a winner for the meat raffle. Let's hear it for Stephen. Yeah.
There we go. Thank you.
Very nice.
You've won the meat raffle. Take that back to Newcastle. They'll love you up there.
That's a lovely meat tray.
Oh, my God. That's pretty impressive.
I'm going to need your winning ticket off you before
you go. Here you go, Joe. Thank you very much. Knock yourself out. That is really... Now, if that's what they look like, I'm quite impressed.
Look at the size of that
too, though. Yeah.
And those lamb chops.
Yum.
Oh, look at the size of them sausages. You're gonna love a sausage.
Oh, I love a sausage sandwich. Yeah.
I love a sausage sandwich.
We obviously cut that. We'd
have to sit in a different order.
Can I take this with me?
You could, of course. We don't pay our guests on Studio 10. We give you meat trays.
Yeah. Better than money.
That's brilliant. Look at that.
Right.
A shot of that.
Fantastic.
fantastic.
It's beautiful.
That was going to show the meat tray.
The meat tray.
Oh,
yeah. Yeah.
He's a convert. You're a convert now.
See?
Fantastic.
You see
you
the value.
You can come to my house.
Yes, it's cook up at Stephen's hotel.
John O's last towel dance.
Don't.
I won't go there.
No. Now, if you want to catch this very funny man, Stephen K. Amos, what does the K stand for, by the way?
The K stands for cool, calm and collected. No, it stands for... it's a Nigerian name and it means the second born of twins.
Oh.
Yes, so my sister is 6 minutes older than myself.
You have a twin?
I have a twin.
Is she funny?
Yes.
Yeah.
No, thank goodness.
But she like meat?
Does she have the meat? That's a rather personal question.
Well, she's...
Hey.
Boom, boom.
Whoa. Just go to our website. Go to the website. This website, stephenkamos.com, for tickets and more information. You are such a champion. Thanks for being on the show.
Thank you.